Now Sarai, Abram's wife, bore him no children. She had an Egyptian maid whose name was Hagar. And Sarai said to Abram, "Behold now, the Lord has prevented me from bearing children. Go into my maid, it may be that I shall obtain children by her." And Abram hearkened the voice of Sarai. So after Abram had dwelt 10 years in the land of Canaan, Sarai, Abram's wife, took Hagar the Egyptian, her maid, and gave her to Abraham, her husband, as a wife. And he went into Hagar, and she conceived. And when she saw that she had conceived, she looked with contempt on her mistress. And Sarai said to Abram, "May the wrong done to me be on you. I gave my maid to your embrace. And when she saw that she had conceived, she looked on me with contempt. May the Lord judge between you and me." But Abram said to Sarai, "Behold, your maid is in your power. Do to her as you please." Then Sarai dealt harshly with her, and she fled from her. The angel of the Lord found her by a spring of water in the wilderness, the spring on the way to Shur. And he said, "Hagar, maid of Sarai, where have you come from, and where are you going?" And she said, "I am fleeing from my mistress Sarai." The angel of the Lord said to her, "Return to your mistress and submit to her." The angel of the Lord also said to her, "I will so greatly multiply your descendants that they cannot be numbered for multitude. Behold, you are with child and shall bear a son, and you shall call his name Ishmael, because the Lord has given heed to your affliction. He shall be a wild ass of a man, his hand against every man and every man's hand against him, and he shall dwell over against all his kinsmen." And Hagar bore Abram a son, and Abraham called the name of his son Ishmael. Abram was 86 years old when Hagar bore Ishmael to Abram.